Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to get started with security using the Elastic Stack. We're going to create a two-node Elasticsearch cluster, configure TLS communication between the nodes, and have a Kibana instance talking to them to analyze the data. As you can see here, I've already downloaded the Elasticsearch and Kibana tarballs as part of our 7.1 distribution. I've extracted both archives. The one other thing I did was copy the Elasticsearch directory twice, one name master, one name node, as this will be a two-node cluster. Let's cd into the master directory. Now I'm going to switch over to the tab with the text file I put together that has all the commands we'll run and the configuration settings to make everything work. Don't worry about trying to write all this down. We'll have a link to a blog post where you can find everything later. The first thing we have to do is generate some certificates that allow the nodes to communicate securely. We have a command here called Elasticsearch certutils. You can run to do this without any of the usual certificate confusion. We'll just paste the command in the master node directory. When it asks us for a file name, let's put it in the configuration directory since that's where Elasticsearch will look for it. Once that's done, we can copy the Elasticsearch configuration file changes we need to enable security and configure TLS. Now we open up the Elasticsearch YAML file, jump to the bottom, and paste the configuration changes. Save the file, and we're ready to start the master node. Once the node is running, it's time to set the passwords for the cluster. In a new terminal, we cd into the master node directory. Then we run the Elasticsearch setup passwords command with the auto option. This will generate random passwords for the various internal stack users. Now let's switch to our node tab and get that configured. The easiest thing we can do is just to copy everything from the master's configuration directory into the node's configuration directory. Then we start the node. We'll see it join the cluster. And if we switch over to the master node, we can see a message there that a node has joined the cluster. Now we have a two-node cluster running. The next thing we'll need to do is configure Kibana. We'll need to add the password for the Kibana user. We can grab that from our passwords terminal. Let's cd into the Kibana directory, edit the Kibana YAML file. It's generally easiest to just search for passwords to find where we have to edit the configuration. First, we have to uncomment the username and password fields. Then we set the username to Kibana, and the password is whatever we copied from the passwords window. Save the file, and we can start Kibana. Once Kibana is running, we can switch over to our web browser and log in to localhost on port 5601. It's going to ask us for a login, and we'll use the Elastic Superuser to configure our new roles and users. Kibana will ask us if we want to load some sample data when it's a new install such as this. Let's load the flight and web sample data for the sake of this example. Once those are loaded, let's check to make sure we have a two-node cluster. We click the Dev Tool icon and click the cluster health. We can see there are two nodes, which is what we expected. Now let's create our roles. Click the configuration icon and find the roles option at the bottom. We're going to name the first role Read Logs. Scroll down to the Index Privileges field and select the log index, then give it the read privilege. The section about spaces is something you'll probably want to investigate once you have security working, but for this particular demo, we're going to skip it. Now let's create another role called Read Flight. We assign the flight index the read privilege. And now we're going to create two users to assign these roles to. We'll name the first user Flight User. Set the password. We can ignore full name and email address. We need to assign our read flight role. And we also need to assign the Kibana user role, as this user will be viewing data in Kibana. Hit create, and let's do it again for the log user. This time we add the read logs role in Kibana user. Okay, we're all set with two new users. Let's log out as the Elastic user and log back in as the log user. If we click on the dashboards icon, we can see there are two dashboards, one for flights and one for logs. Let's check logs first. And here we can see our demo log data. Now, if we try to view the flights dashboard, we can see the dashboard, but we can't see any of the data. This is a place Kibana Spaces can be used to only allow certain users to see certain dashboards. So now let's log out and log back in with the flights user. If we open the log dashboard, this time we can't see any data. We even get an error because Kibana can't access the log index. Now when we check the flight dashboard, we can see we have access to the flight data this time. Congratulations! We now have a two-node cluster configured and two users with restricted access to index data. We have extensive documentation and blog posts on how Elasticsearch Security works and what else you can accomplish with it. Go check it out! Happy searching, everybody!